Ladies and gentlemen, hello, this is Debo over at Land Say Go, and we're back at you with a new standard deck list for a brand new standard. Out of all the types of decks out there, there are two that stand out as being some of the most annoying. Counter Control, and our list for today, Tempo. Specifically Mono Blue Tempo. This deck is cancer-inducing, so let's just get it over with. Let's start out with one of our main combos in the list. We're running three Gadwick the Wizened and three Verity Circle. Verity Circle states that if a creature an opponent controls becomes tapped, without being declared as an attacker, we get to draw a card. Not only does Verity Circle feed into itself with its second ability to be able to pay 5 to tap a creature without flying, but Gadwick, the Wizened, is a perfect synergy to go with it. Gadwick costs 3 blue and X to cast, so we get him down on turn 3 if we want, or we can pay X into him, and when he enters the battlefield, we'll draw that many cards. In this deck, we also want to keep our grip full. So not only do we want to be able to be paying into his mana cost, but if we're able to use a second ability, we can start seeing the synergy here with Verity Circle. Because whenever we cast a blue spell, we can tap a non-land permanent an opponent controls. So we get down Gadwick with the Verity Circle on the field, and then opt. We can then tap an opponent's creature with Gadwick, draw a card from Verity Circle, and then resolve our opt to draw again. Speaking of opt, we'll be running a full playset. We'll also be running 3 Anticipate as well. We want to be able to dig through our deck, and having cheap, instant speed ways of doing so is great. Now for more of the tempo. We'll be running 4 Unsummoned in the main list to be able to bounce our opponent's creatures back into their hands. We can also do tricky things by bouncing our creatures back to our hands for additional value if we so choose. But we'll also be running 2 Runaway together, which works really great with our creature package and at keeping our Gadwick alive. Stolen by the Fey at 2 copies is a way for us to flood the board with blockers or attackers while also keeping our opponent off their big threats. We also have 2 Quench in the main list here to catch some early Okos or other threats and keeping their board clear. Lastly, for the non-creature package, we are running 2 Muyan Ling Sky Dancer. This Planeswalker comes down on turn 3, slows down our opponent's attacks, can gift us with big finishing flyers, or can ultimate and give us the best card draw engine, which can happen. You also have a hidden synergy by grounding an opponent's flyer only to tap it down with Verity Circle to draw a card. The card's great. For our creature package, we have 2 Hypnotic Sprite. By casting its adventure side, we can counter a card with converted mana cost 3 or less, and then also it gives us a 2-1 flyer for 2 mana. A great utility card for something like Gadwick. Queen of Ice at 3 copies is also in the list. For 1 and blue, we can tap down a creature for 2 turns, then cast a 2-3 with a similar ability from Exile for 3 mana. Brazen Borrower gets a full playset in this decklist. It's an annoying card to play against, a great beater in the air, and by bouncing the creature back with a Runaway together, has a lot of staying power. Lastly, we are running 2 Cavalier of Gales. Since the Cavaliers will never truly die, they are a great addition to our list as top-end finishers. We get to brainstorm on ETB, and also get to shuffle them back in and scry on death. Our mana base is really easy. 3 Mystic Sanctuary, 1 Castle of Antris, 20 Islands. Our sideboard seems decent. 2 Aether Gusts for more tempo shenanigans in the right matchup. We're also running 3 Cerulean Drake as a way to counter Mono Red, Cruel, or Rakdos Aggro, since it has Pro Red. We can technically also use it to stop things like Discard as well, but we also have 3 Negate that can come in against this decks that care about non-creature spells, as well as the adventure mechanic. 3 Selective Snare is a good way for us to deal with Goblins, Knights, Elves, Zombies from the Golos deck, Vampires, etc., and can be a really good tempo play for us. We also have 2 Flood of Tears to potentially help stabilize against go-wide decks or decks with huge spells. And lastly, 2 Ugin can come in against the Ceratops and other non-land permanents we need to get rid of like Fires or Planeswalkers. Well, that's the deck. It really is a lot of fun to play, and it is a slow burn with lots of crazy synergy. In playtesting, I even went to time on Arena, something that hardly ever happens. If you love tempo decks, I think you should give this a spin. There is definitely something here. If you would, please like, comment, share, and subscribe, and we'll be talking to you again real soon.